This segment brought to you by Bravo Company USA. Larry Vickers, Vickers Tactical Channel, M3 Grease Gun. This is one of my favorite World War II small arms, and I'll be honest with you, it's one that's kind of an unsung hero. Doesn't get a lot of credit. I would take this over a Thompson submachine gun any day. Thompson's a great gun, very well made, but actually over-engineered, expensive, and very heavy. Grease Gun, 8 pounds or so, a little over, 8-inch barrel, 45 ACP. Magazine does not interchange with a Thompson, which is sad because the Thompson mag is actually a much better magazine. This magazine, inspired by the MP40 Nisten gun, which actually inspired the Grease Gun in general, this is a double to single column magazine, 30 round magazine and 45 ACP. Difficult to load, but a dead ass reliable magazine. I've never seen a Grease Gun malfunction. Now this is the M3 variant. You can identify the M3 versus the M3A1 by this cocking lever on the side. All right, when you see that, you know it's an M3. M3A1 actually had a scallop inside the ejection port, and you put your finger in and cock the bolt in that fashion. The later M3A1 buttstock, which was interchangeable with the M3, by the way, has an L-shaped piece of metal that acts as a magazine loader. It definitely helps in loading that mag. Now, 450 rounds per minute, so it's easy to get off single shots, very controllable and fully automatic. In the early days of Delta Force, before I got there, they used these for CQB purposes, and I can tell you, the suppressed guns have a very long, heavy suppressor, but they're super quiet. And in Delta, when I saw it for CQB purposes, they V-notched the rear sight, so it's much easier to pick up. We're fixing to light it up for you, Vickers Tactical style. We have MagTech 45 ACP hardball coming your way. Enjoy. Thank you.